Hello guys, this is Mikael Kuss speaking, and I'm a concept artist here in the UK working for EA Games right now. And I would like first of all to thank you guys for the support and all the messages that I received. I actually didn't expect it, but it's really cool and nice that you guys are eager to see a demo done by me. And I'm planning to have this tutorial be done in 3 parts. And I'm going to design Soviet mech walker, and it's going to be diesel punky. I really like that. I really like that theme. I'm really also fascinated by all kinds of hardware, mechanical stuff, especially in the World War II era. Now this might be a little bit maybe too high tech for World War II, but I'm definitely trying to keep in the Soviet World War II looking elements in it. So, well, yeah, let's imagine that World War II never ended and Germany and Russia are still waging wars on the Eastern Front. Both sides are trying to come up with the best weapon possible. If you think about it, that was actually the case. Germany came with every new tank design every 6 months, actually, which was crazy. Which, as of now, the American Abrams tank dates back from the 80s and it's still being used. So yeah, that's something very interesting to take note of. Yeah, concept design wise, I decided to make first very rough silhouettes, and that's what's all about, and I will be covering that in the first part of this tutorial. That discovering shapes and just a little bit of the mechanical details is pretty important. Wait, just let me take a sip here because it's already very late and my mouth is running dry. So that's very important, and it's yeah, where was I? Yeah, silhouettes plus the small mechanical bits. Yeah, that's right. I'm trying to do that by exploring some cool shapes with very rough lines, and you see me doing these in on high speed. It's real time, and I really don't care about how tight the lines look like, if you noticed. And the reason why is because I'm thinking only about the shapes and not how well it looks. And I'm not going to present it to anybody, not to any clients or anything. If it were a concept piece I was delivering for a client, so let's pretend it is client work, because we all want to be a concept artist, I hope, I guess. That's why you're watching this video, right? And I'm hope that I will help you here. So yeah, as of now you see me doing the second sketch. I'm really trying to explore how the legs are shaped, what kind of mechanisms are there to keep them a little bit together. Just very rough, nothing fancy yet, because I don't worry about the small details and all the mechanics as of right now. Just the part that makes the mech interesting, which is the shape, the main shape. So yeah, we are going to the third one, and I will repeat this process 7 times, so we'll have 7 fast sketches. So I hope you enjoy this, and I'll be back when we'll begin the better looking part of these sketches. We'll be right back.
We'll New number from Lithuania's own EDU. That is Rain, and we are back once again. Lock it down, turn it up, and strap in for dance music's most consistent hour. The best of the best from top to bottom just for you. You're tuned in to The Hot List with me, Aruna. How's it going? This week I got new goodies for you from the likes of Esteva Juventa, Andrew Bayer, Ilan Bluestone, and many, many more. First up was The Beautiful Sunset by Gal Abutful, reworked by LTN. Followed by the lush and exotic Sensei by Nuera. But up now, I got some super upfront tunage for you, fresh out of the enhanced recordings oven and still warm. This is Chris Nadak and Mozarski with Dreamliner.
Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed the first little doodles I made. Well, it's actually the same process over and over again, repeated 7 times, and it was just a fast idea output. So it's actually brainstorming on paper. So You see that I made with very rough lines some quick designs. You can see suggestions of the small mechanical bits as well. But yeah, what I'm saying is not, of course, the only way to approach this. You might do also silhouette sketches as well, where you take a thick brush and you just go ahead and doodle something. And yeah, you might as well come up with cool shapes here as well. The reason I do it is just because I'm used to it. So it's also something personal, but also something I can share, and maybe you can learn something out of it. Yeah, so here you see me doing the better looking part. So I just simply made a new layer on top of the rougher version, and I'm lining out the basic shapes in a more tighter way. Still really not worrying about how it's going to be look like in the final design, because it's still just fast iterations, just making the lines a little bit thicker and like more defined, so it doesn't look like a sloppy suggestion. It will now actually look like something more solid. So yeah, and of course these concepts could already be used to show to a client and say, hey, these are like the designs I'm making, and this leg goes that way, and it's holden by these kinds of pivots and joints, because I will draw them out in a very fast way. The stuff I wanted to cover first about some stuff about reference. And you also see me that I already made some drawings when I started the videos. You could see them as well. I forgot to mention that. And I'm sometimes taking a look at them, because I already done some drawings before I started this tutorial. The reason is simple. I just didn't do Mech or any mechanical hardware in a long while. And so I warmed myself up with these sketches to help myself get back in the diesel punk mood. Yeah. And it actually helped, and now these sketches are faster to make, because your brain is already used to it, you know? I already picked it up. I'm not going to redraw them, of course. I will try to come up with something new every time. So don't worry, guys. I'm not trying to be lame and redraw a Mech. It's the same design language, of course, but it will be all different designs. So you see me just here copying a leg just to speed up the process. Playing around with the perspective, and it's done. We go ahead further. So yeah, I'm trying to spend not too much time on it, but I tend to over detail stuff very fast. It's a advantage and a disadvantage, but I still did 7 Mechs with a fast color pass in less than 2 hours. I guess that's okay. It's cool. It's a cool output. I mean, in 2 hours you present 7 ideas, and it's nice, you know. You can do like 28 in one day. Yeah, but that might differ, of course, depending on your day and what the design briefing is and how much reference you must gather. So there is not like a solid number of how many designs you must deliver every day. So chill out. It's okay. Yeah, you see me adding some little details, like a hatch or something, a spotlight, and now I'm adding like arms. So the cannons are like carried on these huge metal racks, and I think it's a very interesting. It creates a very interesting silhouette for this design. It's like these arms are sticking out of the main body, and it uses like 50 millimeter cannons or something to shoot its target. So Yeah, and I'm you can see me not worrying how these cannons will be fed by ammo. I just added a cannon, that's it, you know. There's no magazine slot or anything, no ammo belt. Just spam it around, you know, adding some random details. Sometimes when I do line drawings, you know, just doodle around and just hoping for a happy accident to happen. And then you like find forms, you know, so feel free to experiment with that. Never be worried about, oh, it's an empty canvas and it needs to look right and tight just from the start and it needs to look cool. No, just doodle around. You must train your brain, warm up a little. And yeah, you'll get used to it. Collect a reference and yeah, your brain will automatically save them in your head, like almost like carve it like into stone or something. Yeah, which is cool. And when you go to bed, you see all these mechanical bits in front of your eyes. So yeah, this is the second mech. Trying to do something interesting with the legs, but keeping at the same time cliche. So yeah, I'm not trying to create super crazy mechs, but still with some fresh visual hooks. And I think that is important in when you do concept design. Not only mechanical hardware, you want to appeal to your audience, you know? And your audience actually likes cliche stuff. I mean, if you watch The Avatar, it's a movie about a foreign planet, but you still see a jungle which looks like Earth. I mean, some plants are like big and look exotic, but it's not like this whole world is different, because the makers of the movies want to appeal to the audience, so you can feel the jungle, you can feel the air, you can feel the wind blowing, you can, it's all about how rich and believable it feels. Yeah, I think that is a very important part. Yeah, I'm spending here a little bit too much time on the leg, I guess. But yeah, but hey. Yeah, and again, you can play around with that and approach it in many ways. Well, my usual way is that I do it like this, and I thought it would be cool to share this method with you guys, because I actually never post this process. I never show it, because I consider it as a fast idea output. I always only show the final concept, which is a fully rendered piece to where I'm aiming to, and I think that will be covered in part 3 of this whole tutorial. So yeah. And also, you see the same design language also repeats itself, and I think it's a challenge as well, because you want to try to come up with a lot of ideas for the same mechanical walker. I mean, it's the same function, but you want as many variations as possible, and they need to look different, but they need to look like they belong to each other, if you know what I mean. I hope I make sense. You can see me making these round cockpits always in every design. I think it has a very Soviet look to it, with all those these sticking machine guns out of it. And yeah, it's a very interesting shape, I think. Which I also used in my previous designs when I was doing concept art for March of War. So yeah, I'm using it as much as possible. Just love it. Here you see me finishing the hatch, adding the barrels, some small details here and there, just to add some complexity, you know. But still, as you can see, not really worrying about the tightness of the lines. So yeah. And as I mentioned, reference gathering. I will add reference to this tutorial. So if you download the file here from Gumroad, you will have all the references added, which I used to create these mechs, which include the awesome T-34 tank, which is one of my favorites. I actually used a lot of visual hooks from the T-34 tank in these designs, like the small mechanical bits, the bits on how the machine gun is attached, like here for example, on the second mech on the end of his cockpit. You might notice that if you now look at the T-34, I just actually literally copied it. It just looks cool. And some of the cannons here, the weapons I'm about to design, are going to be based on the ZIS field gun, which was a Soviet gun carried just on wheels, and it was used as an anti-tank weapon. But it could also be used as an artillery piece. It's very versatile. Soviets were very versatile. I really like that. So yeah, adding some details here and there just to add the complexity. And you start to see that it already looks tighter than the other line drawing, because we are about to present it, right? You want to... I'm sorry, be right back. I'm sorry guys, I had to leave like that. It was very unprofessional of me, but yeah. Fuck it. I had an unexpected call. It was actually Darek Zabrodsky. We actually cheer each other up. I mean, we were both like sitting like in a cave drawing all day. So yeah, you need this kind of a way to socialize just a little bit, even though it's on Skype and you're still like miles apart, you know. Alright, without sounding gay, of course. Anyway, we are continuing here with my Mech sketches. I guess I'm still being here busy with the second leg. I'm not even sure if I'm not synced up pretty well, but yeah. The second Mech is now coming to an end. And I actually will also do a color pass in these ones. The reason for that is that even though these line arts would be enough to present an idea, it's always cool to present ideas in a cool way. And by adding some color and some value into it, you make the forms you just designed and created a little bit more visible, so everybody will see what you mean with these fast looking lines, you know. It's almost like the problem I sometimes have is that I sketch around something and it becomes really complex after a while, and people often don't see what I mean. They don't see the forms, they don't see the balls, they don't see the mechanics. And yeah, then it's very handy to do just a fast color pass, a fast value fill, if I may say it like that, and the forms will start to pop out, because you will lit the surface a little bit, you will add a little bit of shadow where shadow should be, and the sketch will overall take shape. And it's a very nice way to present a design if you have time. I mean, it's like eating spaghetti or out of a dirty plastic plate, or well presented and a nice looking plate with decoration all around it, you know? Even though the spaghetti is the same, you will pick the spaghetti which is served in a better looking plate. I think I got that line from some other tutorial, I can't remember which one. Yeah, but I thought it's a cool idea. And so the same goes for concept art, you know. You might present the same idea on a very ugly piece of paper, and without color, just lines, and say, yeah, it's rough, but it looks cool and everything, and still idea, you know, it's still valid. But if you present it with some nice color pass and in a very clean way, everything is tight, then yeah, it's more of an eye candy then. So yeah. So the third Mech has started here already, and again I will repeat this process until the seventh Mech is done. So I will be back when we'll start the color pass and talk a little bit more, and maybe I'll talk about some things which for now I can't remember what I was talking about. But yeah, anyway, I hope you guys enjoy it. Oh, by the way, I just mirrored the image to see some to see mistakes, to see if the perspective is correct. So I also advise you guys to do the same, of course, which is an old trick, you know. Traditionally, artists used to put like drawings and paintings onto a mirror and spot mistakes like that, but in today's software, you just mirrored that shit. So yeah. Yeah, finish off the leg, the foot in particular. So yeah, enjoy the rest of it, and I'll be back when the color starts.
Fresh new music there forthcoming on Enhanced. That was Leo with She's the One. Before that, another banger from a producer who can seemingly do no wrong. Estiva teamed up there with Johan Vilberg on a tune called Mondays. That one after the new one from Suspect 44, blowing up the Beatport trance chart with that as we speak. That's his new tune entitled Amazing, which also happens to describe this week's tune of the week. Coming at you right now. Check it out. Cornucopia of talent on this one. Hot List heroes Mayan and Shane 54 teamed up with Wunderkind EDM prodigy Cole Plante, topped off with a killer vocal by Coco LaRue, wrapped up and revved into overdrive by Juventa. And well, you almost can't go wrong with this one. And the stats are in to prove it, making their debut at number 42 on the Billboard dance chart. This week's Firestarter is Lie to Me. Turn it up.
I can see a storm and it's coming my way. I think I'm gonna drown if you say what you say. Just tell me I'm the only one that you think about when I'm not around, yeah. And I don't wanna know what I already know. Just keep it to yourself, leave me out in the cold. Never let the words come out, keep them locked inside and just stay. I'm
So hard to let you go. Though my mama told me so. That you would run for me. Run for me. It's obvious to see that there ain't no you and me no more. No more. And now I finally realize we could only say goodbye. Let it go. Let it go. When the day kicks in, I'm ready for whatever tonight. I'm over you. There's a guiding light inside of me that's ready to shine. I'm over you. I'm over you.
gorgeous from Elon Bluestone there. That's his take on Lakota by Cesar. Before that was Mirth with an M from Andrew Bayer, preceded by the new slammer from Mason and Dragon with Sharon Durson on the vocals. A hit if I ever heard one. That track's called I'm Over You. Got time to squeeze in just a few shouts now. Let's get to it. Happy birthday to Adam Jones in Hermitage, Pennsylvania, to Aaron Bannister in Jacksonville, Florida, and to diehard fan Raya Topolniski in Calgary, Canada. She says, last year on my birthday, I got to see you DJ live for the first time, and it was such a treat. I really hope you'll be back in Western Canada again soon. You are truly a gem in today's EDM scene. Thank you, sweetie. Happy birthday to all of you. Landel Colota from Brazil sends a shout to his girl, Natalia, who's studying to enter medical school. Will Holiday in Quincy, Illinois, sends a shout to his wife, Christy, saying, she means the world to me. I love her more and more with each passing day. We both listen to your podcast while at the gym. And lastly, happy anniversary to Daniela from Ahmad Kansa in Lebanon. Want to hear your name on the hot list? It's easy. Just write in to podcast@arunamusic.com. Let us know what you're celebrating, if anything. And don't forget to tell us where you're from. Back to business now. We got about 5 minutes left. You know what that means. It's cool down time. Breathe deep and enjoy.
Slow burner.
You
Alright, so cool, here we are. Adding the value fill of these mechs, as promised, of course. I hope you enjoyed the part where I did the tighter line drawings. I hope you guys already learned something a bit out of it. Then keeping it all professional, maybe not professional, but keeping it all tight is not that important in the first brainstorm phases of your designs. So that's the reason why you want to be a concept designer, to come up with as many ideas as possible in a short amount of time. And I think it's cool and challenging, and it keeps me going every day. I wake up and I go like, hey, yes, another day when I can do a bunch of sketches, which can look all different. Some of them might look crazy, some of them might look off, but yeah. Expect a lot of ideas to be rejected and thrown away. In the end, you can save them all and show it in your portfolio. And that's also the awesome part about art, that every day you work on art, it's actually visible on what you've worked on. So yeah, that's very cool. And yeah, so let's try to cover something about color here. So I picked a very muddy default, perhaps a little bit boring looking color here. I didn't even decide if that's going to be like the final color when I'm going to do the final design. It's just to give away the Soviet mood and to pick a color that might perhaps fit these mechs in a winter kind of environment, but making them completely white would be silly. So it's like a dirty light mud, I guess. I hope that makes sense in a wintry environment. And still, I'm not even sure if I'm going to put these mechs in a winter environment when I'm going to make like the final looking illustrations of these. So we'll just see. For now, I'm just I just was thinking about making a follow up on my previous concepts, which perhaps you guys saw, like that death ray soldier standing in a winter kind of background. Although the background is not that defined, but it's supposed to be snow on which he's standing. So I actually used the same kind of color of the body. And yeah, again, I will repeat this process. For now, I'm just not even adding shading. Oh wait, I will add shading now. Yeah, I will. And yeah, you can already see that the silhouettes are popping out, you know. So not only you see, I mean, I see what I drew, you know. But people who don't know don't see in one glance what I just made up here. This value fill will help them see the forms pop out in a much better way. So yeah, it's a very handy way to show off your main idea here. And I keep the line drawing, you know, because the line drawing is there to keep all the details and to keep the whole piece together. So I'm not going to make a render out of this until the whole line drawing is gone. I just made a new layer on below the line drawing layer, and I'm still actually holding the first doodle layer with the very rough lines. It just adds this extra complexity, I guess. I never turn it off, actually. It's something that I just kept through my concepts, a way of work. Which doesn't mean you should do the same, of course. Just again, personal. adding a little bit shadow. So you already see that it's popping out in a better way. You can see where the armor ends. Like, for example, I added this darker part where like the joint starters. Where the joints start and the more complex bits. So these areas are darker because like parts are sticking out and they cover each other with self-shadowing. And then here again, I'm trying to add some highlights, but that kind of failed. So I will change that. It doesn't look like I want it. Looks a little bit too simple, I guess. So yeah, I will erase it in a while and then redo it, I guess. So yeah, maybe some technical information about this. So this file, I started out with 9000 by 9000. Yeah, it's actually very big, but my Camtasia was a little bit laggy. So I reduced the file by 50%. But that's the resolution I'm working on usually. It's just a very huge file. So it's I just feel the comfort with it. You know, you can zoom in and play around with details without seeing the pixels. It gives me this natural analog feel. It's a nice feel of freedom, I guess. Yeah, and I do like freedom, you know. I mean, when I doodle around, I tend to not worry about how the final piece will look like. I'm just carry myself away and just sketch around like there is no tomorrow, you know, and find shapes, explore it, and that's how you come up with designs. Of course, with proper reference, which is very important, you know. So yeah, here you see me adding some red decals, just for a nice, interesting color balance, I guess. So yeah, adding here some Soviet star, just to give that Soviet feel, and to add some color as well. Otherwise, it could look very, very boring. You know, even though these are very fast silhouette sketches for now, you want to attract the eye in a minor way, I guess, because there's nothing fancy about it, but just some red spots here and there, you know, might attract the eye. So I guess that's cool. And that was actually my problem for a long time. You know, I made decent looking concepts, but my colors were very boring, you know, and people tend to say, yeah, it's so dark and so grim and everything. So now I'm trying to add color, you know, add some more color to make it look more interesting, to create this visual hook, not only form wise, but color comp wise, I guess. Yeah, if that makes sense. Just attracts the eye a little bit. It catches your attention, I hope. I hope this catches your attention. Yeah. So this is already the third value sketch I'm doing. And the first one and the second one are not the final, I guess. I mean, I will detail them a little bit out, because I wanted to have this tutorial for not longer than 2 hours, but I actually fit in really easily, like in 1 hour and 52 minutes. So yeah, I still had time to fix some little mistakes here and there and to improve it a little bit. So yeah, and yeah, and a fun fact about colors is that I spoke with one of my clients recently. He's a very good art director. He's a cool guy, and he had this fun fact that we were talking about how my coloring sucked in the beginning when I was early in the stage of a concept artist. Not that's super bad as now, but like in the first stages of my career, I just literally sometimes I didn't use color at all, you know. I use color. I made color images, but the colors are very dark and grim. And he told that guys have that problem, and that women are much better in color comps. So that's why when you see like female artists, they always have these interesting colors, and sometimes they overdo it, in my opinion, like super rainbow, super saturated colors. But sometimes they hit a spot and attracts your eye and creates very cool visual hooks. So yeah, we need more female concept artists, guys, to make this world more colorful. Yeah, so here I'm adding like a darker shadow, And you already see that the forms are popping out now, even better, I guess. So it's a very cool way to show off your ideas in an efficient way, I hope. So you see me doing these soft shadow just underneath the edge of the armor. So now you can see where the armor part is and where the mechanical looking stuff is. So yeah. And a little bit about the mechs. These are like standard fighting assault mechs. Although the mech I'm coloring in now is like a heavy howitzer mech, and I gave him very strange looking feet, I guess. I just now realized that I regret that I left it that way. I mean, it looks like a crow or something. It's like these weird claws. But yeah, I tried something out. Again, it's just playing with the forms, you know, and nothing is final. So yeah, so what you see here is I'm just coloring it this huge howitzer. And I mean, yeah, I gave him this feed because the recoil of this huge howitzer needs some support, you know. So his feet are really huge. And again, he has this familiar looking cockpit, which I introduced almost in every design here. It just keeps the Soviet design language at its place, I guess. So yeah, and on the other side of the mech is like another weapon. It's like it's not a Gatling cannon. It just there's like three barrels and they fire like shrapnel, like a huge shotgun. So yeah, when groups of infantry are trying to approach this mech, it uses its other weapon for targets that are close, that are nearby. You know, you won't use a huge howitzer to shoot a target which is like 10 meters away from you. So yeah. And yeah, let's think what I can cover here more before I leave you guys with the rest of the coloring part. Oh yeah, and again, because this is my first tutorial, I might have screwed up some things, so please feel free to send me feedback on my Facebook or just email me, and I always try to answer every message. I always try to do it. Although time is not on my side, I always try to cover every. To respond to every message. So yeah, feel free, because I want to continue with these tutorials. It's very cool that you guys were so eager to see my process, and yeah, it will not stop on mechanical stuff only. I want to cover a lot of stuff. So hope it all will be well. Just adding some small shades to make the forms even look better. Now I introduced a new color, like for the shells. I just used a very, very sloppy gray looking color, just to make the viewer know that it's not like a static part of the mech. Just to let you guys know that's an ammo belt. So yeah. This howitzer only reloads. This howitzer only reloads when it shoots all its shells and goes back to its base, and then it's fed manually by a group of conscripts or something. So yeah. So yeah. Yeah, I realized that I didn't speak much about the design choices I made for these. For these mechanical workers. So let's talk about the mechanical guy, the mechanical walker I'm coloring in now. So this one I think is inspired by T-34 the most. It's actually a T-34 turret. Then I added a spine, a mechanical huge spine with some legs. I just left it for now for some reason. Went back to the other mech. You know, you just sometimes you get tired of one mech, or you just start with a new one, and then you realize, hey, the other one looks not finished yet, or I want to add some little details here and there. So yeah, I encourage you to do the same. I mean, you're not like a factory, so you can't spam forever. Sometimes you just need to take a break, drink some tea, or talk to some friends, and then come back hours later, and then you will have like a this fresh and fruity look again on your concept, and then you might see things from a different perspective. So going back to the design, I started coloring. It's a T-34 turret. Its cannon is also like placed in the turret, like on a normal tank, and then I extended the turret with a back cockpit on the rear part of the turret. It's sticking a little bit out. It looks like a spider now or something, like a butt of a spider. And then on the other side, it has three rocket launchers. So it might be not clear. You might think it's part of his body, or it's a different, or you might think it's a different weapon. But just to make sure you guys know what you're seeing, it's a triple-barreled rocket launcher. So yeah, maybe I failed here to show my idea off here. Now for some reason I went back to the second mech. You know, it's all just random. I just do what I feel like. Oh, and I introduced another color here, like adding some rust on the exhaust. And that's what you will see in real life. Exhausts on especially on World War II equipment, they tend to rust very fast because they were painted as well. They had the same, usually they had the same color as the whole body, but because the fume and the heat on the exhaust was always there because of the running engine, the paint chipped off after a while. And when the paint chips off, then only the metal is exposed, and then yeah, when rain hits you, it starts to rust. So yeah. And I know that because I read stuff and I do a lot of reference. So the more reference you do, again, the more believable your stuff will be. All these funny details, you know, I just added this rust, and not randomly. I just read somewhere, and I know it from reference that happens in the real world, and it already creates a nice visual hook, which is believable as well, you know. So yeah, what else can I say? I would like to to thank you for watching. Thank you for all the support, and I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. The second part of this tutorial will be focused on the final design. Yeah, I might still do two or three variations, but I will go into detail, like hardcore detail, you know. And I'll do it by tight line drawing as well. Yeah, I think that's the fastest and most trusted way. It's a personal preference, I guess. And I will try to explain why I add detail there, why it should be there, and how you can do that stuff on your own. Like, not only design-wise, but I also have a lot of messages incoming about how I do my line drawing. It's maybe I should cover that as well. It's very important to train, of course, the coordination. I mean, a Wacom tablet is different than paper, but you're a human being and you can learn new things, so don't worry. It's when you do it a lot, it becomes easy. Try to always make these lines out of your elbow and very fast. Don't be afraid, you know. Don't go very slow, otherwise your hand will start shaking and then, yeah, weird things might happen. Just keep your, try to keep your line smooth. Maybe it's easy to say, but that's the truth actually. I don't worry about how the lines might look. I mean, I do worry, but like it needs to be like in your system. I mean, shit, I don't know if I'm explaining it in the right way, but first of all, you should do it a lot. You should train it, like just try to come up with forms or like make studies, you know, like make line drawings of cars, of tanks, and then check after if it matches the real life tank you just redrew, you know. So yeah, adding some shading here and there still. So I will leave you guys, I think, till this tutorial is finished. Later on I will add some shadows on the ground just to make it, just to give it some 3D space. Otherwise the background will be all flat and boring. And that will be it. Again, thanks a lot. I hope you guys learned a little bit out of it. And yeah, let me know if you enjoyed it. Feel free to message me on feedback on what should be improved. It's the first time I'm doing this kind of thing. Actually, well, I've done some fast tutorials like 3 minutes and 5 minutes, but now I'm trying to cover as much as stuff as possible. So yeah. I hope you guys keep it real, stay safe, stay out of trouble, and yeah, see you guys soon again. Thanks a lot, and enjoy the rest of it, and bye bye. So silent, no violence, but inside my head.
wicked ways. So I'm moving up, up and away, up, up and away, up, up and away.
I'm a victim. Hey, this is Ferry Corsten, and you're listening to my new track with Aruna, Live Forever, right here on the Hot List.
Take. I've been hiding from the heat of the sun.